ไม่ใช่เพราะว่าตามไม่ทันนะคือรู้อยู่แล้วล่ะเรื่องนี้มันจะเกิดขึ้นกระแสมันเกิดขึ้น2-3 อาทิตย์ที่แล้วแต่เจนขอเติมอะไรหน่อยเรื่องที่คนไทยถูกคนต่างชาติเหยียดมันไม่ใช่เป็นเรื่องใหม่แล้วมันยังไม่จบด้วยแล้วที่ผ่านมานะคะก็ดูวิดีโอคนไทยตอบโต้กลับ ซึ่งขอบอกไว้ก่อนว่าภูมิใจมากแล้วก็ขอบคุณมากนะคะที่ดูแลปกป้องศักดิ์ศรีผู้หญิงไทยแล้วก็ประเทศไทยแต่เจนขอเติมอะไรหน่อยเพราะว่าในเมื่อเจนอยู่ในฐานะที่เป็นคนไทยไปโตที่อังกฤษมี2 สัญชาติเจนจะรู้ว่าอะไรมันคืออะไรบ้างในทางประเทศของตะวันตกนะคะมาสายนิดแต่ก็ยังแรงนะคะ
When you pay attention to the passport rolls like they're getting women from like the DR Colombia
yes.
The Philippines Thailand mm. like women can that can speak very little English
อุ๊ยขอประทานโทษด้วยนะคะที่พูดภาษาคนผิวขาวไม่เก่งมันเป็นเพราะว่าประเทศไทยไม่เคยตกเป็นเมืองขึ้นของใครยินดีต้อนรับเข้าสู่ประวัติศาสตร์ชาติไทย
Women that don't have education
Do you think these Thai universities are just for show or something? Look, there are many more. Look at the interior design of this particular Thai university. You see, plant centuries help the students to learn better. You know, calm environment, no stress.No mass shooting at uni, unlike in the US. And I'm 100% sure that she can't even locate these countries that she's disrespecting on an empty world map like this. Anyway, the interior design is very thoughtful. If I own a university, I would plant lots of weed just like this. No stress. If I start racially profiling her, she'll be screaming BLM. So then why would it be okay to racially profile Asian people so casually? Get the f*** out of here.You uneducated clown. And here is another ignorant clown who's bitter because she's got triggered by this one question. What does she think about the passport bros? What's her reaction?
Well, f*** you. Go away. Go find your women wherever you want if you're not satisfied. I don't know what to tell you. If you want a woman who barely even speaks English...
Barely speak English. It's a fucking bastard language. I am 100% sure she doesn't even know it.Anyway, there are many languages being taught in Asian schools, including your bastard language. There are also compulsory components in the Thai national curriculum. It helps raise the economy. The thing is, not all Thai people care about being fluent in your bastard language, since we've got our own language. Remember, Thailand has never been colonized before, so obviously we're not going to be good at other languages such as English. We weren't colonized!
And just has to suck your dick, go for it.
Triggered. Immediately.
She's just mad because she's been begging for dicks long time. But she ain't been successful. Asian woman has more than just sex to offer, and I swear the United States has the largest porn industry in the world, filled with women like her, swallowing multiple men all at once. Now that's a lot of sucky to do, but no real love to gain. Me no love you long time?Also, Kim Kardashian is an idol in their country, and her fame started with a sex tape. How dare you look down on Thai women and Thailand? Let me translate a Thai song for you. Just go down, hurry up and down. You can die tonight, just go. Shout out to the men who stood up for us.
When you go find a wife in the Philippines or Thailand or Eastern Europe or wherever these places are that are overseas, I'm assuming you mean they're more biddable, that they're less outspoken, they don't demand anything of you, that they're just happy to be rescued from their poverty-stricken life of no opportunity, and in return, all they have to do is subject themselves to your advances.I do wonder at your motivation for why you want to go overseas to find a partner. Is it because you prefer your woman without opinions, unable to fight back, and vulnerable?
I've got a long list for you as well, love. Let's see. Clueless. A lot of shit comes out of your mouth. Age faster than Asians. Oblivious to being prejudiced against us. Life full of pain and loneliness. Subjected to die alone. Have no man. Cannot get a date.And undesirable. As well as degrading us, she also thinks all passport bros are a bunch of psychopaths. Or is she just projecting herself onto these men because they don't want to subject to her advances of mind controlling and brainwashing? Manipulation is not cool. Stay safe, people.
Passport pros are people who specifically go from country to country to country trying to find women, exotic flavors, to dabble in, right? Passport bros are like, oh man, I can't find any good women in the States, so I'm gonna have to go somewhere else in the world. Like, women are inherently different in every other country.
We are different from you. Do I need to state the obvious?
Okay, let's start off with, we've got your men to settle down with us and not with you. We're humble, not obnoxious or loud like you. And let's see where the United States rank on this list from most to least population with obesity. Number one being the most obese, 200 being the least obese.
Let's look at the woman, because the topic is about trashing other women. The irony. Here it is, number 30 on the list. Thailand is number 154.
The US may not be number one on this list, but so many other countries are thinner than the US. And men from their country prefer healthy women, you know, so that the medical care won't cost so much in the future and that they get to live longer to see their grandchildren grow up.
It really starts becoming weird when you go to third world countries or countries that are not as advanced as ours.
Oops, sorry. This is America.
This is America. Don't catch you slipping now. Don't catch you slipping now. Look what I'm whipping now. This is America.
Also, Thailand has a better and cheaper healthcare than the US. Look at these comparisons. Anyway, by the look of her, she needs medical attention immediately. She's been waiting on the list for too long just to be seen. Maybe she should come and use our healthcare system, since we offer a high standard healthcare service for cheaper.
And a lot of these women are desperate.
But we're not desperate enough to start hating on people who found love. You're desperate.
So they're going to take you up on that offer, right? They want someone who is going to be submissive to them.
I'm sorry, who the fuck are you talking about being submissive? Many countries have fought for their independence from the colonizers and won. How is this being submissive?
But Thailand has always been independent, so we're not submissive to anyone. I mean, it's bloody written down in our national anthem.
Anyway, this is just a fraction of the anthem that I wanted to highlight. But we actually know all the words to the Thai national anthem because it makes sense.
And what better way to find someone who's submissive to them than to find a woman who is at your beck and call?
She should meet my mom and my Thai female relatives. I mean, where do you think I get this feisty personality from?
And also, I've never seen my stepdad, who's white, treats my mom like a robot that is at someone's beck and call. But I've seen them working together as a team, and the marriage is still going strong.
Besides, many women from the third world countries or developing nations are strong people. Maybe they should demonstrate how strong they are by smacking her. I'm joking. I mean, kinda. No, wait. I mean, these women have strong mentality. So when she's trashing us, we just want to smack the fat out of her.
Well, because, you know, the only reason she's in the United States is because of you.
And many men from your country wants to escape to other countries. It's because of you. Sweet cow. We would actually call her a buffalo in Thai.
Also, you're in America because of what? Because of what? You're not meant to be there. You're supposed to be back in Europe.
Sounds to me like a lot of control issue, right? And to be honest, ladies, these aren't the type of men that we want anyway.
We don't want them either. So we'll just select the good ones that want us.
Right. These men want a woman that they can control. And because they can't find it here in America, because it's frowned upon to, like, own a human here, they go to other places in the world where they can legally own a human.
Would you please stop living in those slavery days with your white supremacy thinking. Can you do that? Nobody can own anyone legally out there. And if they do, it's called human trafficking, and that's illegal, and it's a worldwide issue. What drugs are you on anyway? America, you need to stop pushing drugs into your people through advertisements and stop charging them high medical bills.
These passport predators are the bottom of the barrel. And the reason they're going overseas to get women is because we don't want them. And they know if they go overseas, they're more likely to find a woman who will do whatever it takes to secure a better life for her family.
First of all, you're on your way to looking like this. Secondly, can you tell me who this is? Isn't she the infamous gold digger who'll do whatever it takes to secure her victim's bank account? The bitch even put on blasts of how to find potential victims to manipulate.
The athletes, none of them use condoms, really. So if y'all really want to try to come up off a check off a man, I mean, you could just fuck an athlete. They're really dumb.
Oh, she's a gold digger.
And furthermore, your OnlyFans space is huge. And those tickets are being paid for your woman from your country to fly over to Dubai just so they can sell that fake, that BBL, that leaking, stinking butts for a high-maintenance lifestyle. And if you think I'm one of them just because of this one post, I'm sorry to disappoint you, but I ain't got no account on there. Also, you're not looking from an artistic point of view that it was Halloween. I dressed up as a demon, a succubus. The lyrics of the song? Everything just goes together? The mean girl's jokes? Do I need to explain?
In girl world, Halloween is the one night a year when a girl can dress like a total slut and no other girls can say anything about it. The hardcore girls just wear lingerie and some form of animal ears.
Doesn't she look great, honey?
What are you?
I'm a mouse. Duh.
Anyway, other women complimented me on this, so thanks, ladies.
Trust me, we don't want them, and we appreciate you guys taking out the trash for us.
And is she taking herself to the gym and to the beauty salon right now? Because she's sitting in her car looking like trash herself. It's going to cost her a lot of money and efforts just to look at least half decent. Sweetheart, just because your thing down there dried up years ago doesn't mean passport bros love life shit too. Take yourself out of social media and explore the world outside the US. If you can afford to.
Clearly, underage girls. Do y'all realize when y'all make comments on videos like how women are just jealous when we're talking about minors, meaning children, that y'all are basically telling the world what you've done or want to do? Mostly, I'm pretty sure a lot of you.
Oh my gosh, she's gone spastic.
This is why I tell everybody.
Nobody can understand your speech for your spasticism.
A man will do what he do to your 13-year-old or a 13-year-old if he know he can get away with it. Why would you think a woman would be jealous of a child? You stupid, nasty fool.
Anyway. Those fake eyelashes doesn't make her look any less masculine. Even with my head shaved, I still look more feminine than her. And I still got a man who loves me and a family of my own. And what she's committing right now is false accusation and even defamation against this random happy man who's obviously with a grown woman who just happened to look underage. Not everyone who looks younger than her are underage. I'm 33 and petite. And I surprise people all the time when I tell them I'm a mother of two big kids. Also, why would he expose himself like this if he was a pedo? Not even actual pedos want to expose themselves so brazenly like this. It's not like you can just go anywhere. Once you landed in that country, you'd be like, yeah, you, where can I find children to sleep with? You can't do that. It's the same thing with like going around asking people, where can I find drugs? Which is why there are such things as secret pedophile rings. You know, the key word secret, not public. Anyway, they would get in trouble with the authority over there. Or anywhere, wherever they go. And as well as having their reputations ruined. Anyway, this manly woman is chatting crap. And if you got problems with age gap in overseas or something, Hugh Hefner, anyone?
passport bros are real and saying they'd go into other countries to find more submissive women. No. Which means they are strategically picking countries that are stereotyped for having very relaxed, if any, rules around these two things. So they're going to other countries not to find submissive wives, but to find women and girls that they,
Okay, so according to her, all passport bros love to stereotype other countries as exploitative. My stepdad and my uncle-in-law, who are white men, don't fall into these stereotypes that these ladies are claiming. And they're the old-school passport bros. That's right, this shit ain't new. Neither of them and many more passport bros have the same mindset as this. It looks like she's inflating. Many passport bros find their woman, get married, settle down over there, or what they do is come over to the West together and live together. That's it. Build a life together anywhere. Could be in Asia, could be in the West. Doesn't matter. And those that do have that mindset, like Jeffrey Epstein, Prince Andrew, Gary Glitter, who flew out to abuse children, are not passport bros. They're just disgusting criminals. Jimmy Savile from England, who was knighted by the Queen before the scandals became mainstream, didn't even have to fly out because he abused children within his own country for decades.
A fella could get used to all this. I think he really could get used to it. So, ladies and gentlemen, all we can say is good night from all of us here on Top of the Pop.
And he got away with it because the media, these children's hospitals, schools that he was involved with, kept it on the hush before his death. Not a passport bro, but definitely a disgusting criminal. So, learn to differentiate between these two things. And stop demonizing all passport bros. And if you think my country is relaxed about sexual assault and domestic violence, you need to start reading this. And can you please tell me why Jeffrey Epstein and R. Kelly got away with abusing underage girls for years? I mean, with R. Kelly's case, I get it. His victims were black. And in the US, they're not prioritized as much. However, with Jeffrey Epstein's case, it's on a bigger and much more powerful scale. Because those white victims almost didn't get the justice. His first sentence was a joke. A sad joke. Look at this. In case you were wondering, here's the definition of work release. Controversial plea deal, eh? By the way, we don't know how many underage victims have been abused by Jeffrey Epstein and Prince Andrew. And their pedophilia ring. Their secret pedophilia ring. Secret, you know? Anyway, what I'm saying is that these victims that came out to expose these criminals are US citizens. They're from the US. Sorry. Oh my God, I'm so sorry. But anyway, human trafficking is on a global scale. It's everywhere. And even first world countries have human trafficking. Jimmy Savile got away with murder because he died before he could be brought to justice. However, Prince Andrew is still out there, not in prison, because he paid off his victims. I mean, the justice system is not really here for us, for people like me. It's just to protect people like them. I mean, I'm not saying that I want to commit a crime, but if I was to smoke my weed outside in public, I'd definitely get in trouble with the police. Both the US and the UK are supposed to be first world countries. They're supposed to have a working justice system, but apparently not.
And yet, these ladies are chatting crap about other countries instead of looking within their own country. You see, there are problems in every country. But if you keep thinking that your country is perfect than everywhere else, it will only make you overlook the problems and the victims within your very own country. And nothing gets solved. And if you think it's only the men who are predators, then why is this female predator not in prison for abusing a boy aged 13? Just because she gave birth to his child. And you see, it happened recently. Not 10 or 20 years ago. We're talking about now. From 2022 to this year, 2023. But if you do want to go back into the past and look into cases like this, they do exist. For the guys who left the comments underneath my post, clapback number 2, you guys are right. These Passport Bros haters be looking like 1 out of 10 on a scale of attractiveness, and then went minus 9.5 out of 10 when they open the big mouth but don't open their minds. My partner's fart sounds more pleasant than these ladies combined together.